can actually, you can see just how much more more space there is than the actual playing area. You can see the most thing up here, kind of in see what it is. And it's about 57, 58 feet wide, and typically a show then will only play about as deep as it is wide, at the deepest, and usually not even that far up.
For both of us.
The Cultural Trust owns almost all of the rest of the major performing arts centers downtown. So the Benedum Center, the Byam Theater, the O'Reilly Theater, the Cabaret Theater Square, those are all Cultural Trust venues. Hines Hall is still independently operated, although we partner with them and actually do some of our Broadway shows down there. So it's kind of all, we try to keep it all in the family as much as possible.
The stage was, because it was a movie theater, so the stage was originally quite small. And when the Cultural Trust took over the building, what we did was we actually bought all of the land behind it, cut off the back of the original building, and built this whole new structure behind it.
This console is where they call the shows from, so that's where the stage manager sits to give all the cues to the actors and the crew and everyone else and tell them when to fly the sets in and out and change the lighting and when the actors get their calls when they're in their dressing rooms so that they know if they're a half an hour or 5 minutes or places. Watch your step. And none of you are probably watch your heads.
It's like Alice in Wonderland.
We actually call that the Alice in Wonderland Hall, yeah. Itself is a whole system of catwalks that actually takes you from all the way above the stage to all the way above the spotlight booth and winds all the way around that dome, and that's actually how we change all of the rosette lights up there, the lights that are set back in the octagonal insets. Those are actually changed from above. You walk out to them and you unscrew a kind of... Oh, yes.
I just noticed the big ones. I didn't even really pay attention. Yeah. It's so well lit.
Yeah, there are lots of them. And each one of those has, I believe, 8 light bulbs in it. There are a lot of light bulbs. Leaving aside the costs of production, the costs of ticketing, anything like that, just the sort of physical carry costs of this building, paying the utilities, paying to keep it clean, paying to keep it operational, run on the order of about $10,000 a day. So it's a very expensive proposition to run into somebody like this.
Skybird in a distant world.